Hey scientists, check this out. It's Saturn. That's another planet. Earth is a planet too, but Saturn looks a lot different than Earth, doesn't it? I'll need to make a sculpture of Saturn to add to my collection of outer space clay creations. What's that, Mia? There are more planets? Venus? Mars? Neptune? I think I have a lot of sculpting to do. Let's take a look at some of these other planets and learn more about how they are similar and different from our planet, Earth. Okay, I think my new sculptures are ready for a little demonstration. Here we go. We have the Earth and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 other planets. And of course, the star of the show, the Sun. The Sun and these 8 planets are all part of our solar system. The solar system is like a big neighborhood in outer space. Some planets are closer to the Sun, like this one, and others are much farther away, like this one over here. The planets closer to the Sun are much hotter than Earth. Why do you think that is? Remember that our heat and light comes from the Sun. So the closer we are, the brighter and warmer it gets. And the planets farther away from the Sun than Earth? You guessed it. It's colder and darker there. You might have noticed the planets are all different sizes, colors, and materials too. Like Saturn here. It's a really big planet made of gas, with bright rings made of ice and rocks that hang around it. And Mars is smaller than Earth. It's made of red rocks and dust. It's a lot colder, but it's the most similar planet to Earth. And like the Earth, some planets have moons. Not all of them though. Mercury and Venus don't have any moons, but Jupiter, it has almost 100 moons. But there's one thing that makes the Earth really special that no other planets have. Can you think of what that is? Earth is the only planet we can live on. One reason for this is because the Earth is the only planet with air and water, which we know living things need to survive. And there's one thing all of these planets have in common or do the same. Each of these planets all orbit or move in a path around the Sun. Do you remember how we learned about the Moon and how it moves around the Earth about once each month? All of the planets in the solar system, including Earth, orbit around the Sun. Let's look at the Earth's orbit first. It moves in a big oval, like this. It's moving pretty fast, but it has a really far way to go to make it all the way around. The Earth's orbit around the Sun takes 365 days. That's 1 year. Wait a second. That's not the Earth's only movement, right, Mia? Pause the video to take a moment to remember. What is the other movement the Earth makes? Write it down in your science sketchbook, say it aloud, or think it to yourself. I'll think too, and I'll let you know what I remember when you get back. We learned that the Earth also rotates or spins in a circle. That happens once every day. And it's why we have night and day. But the Earth's orbit, or its path around the Sun, completes once every year. Some planets move around the Sun faster than others, like Mercury here. See how much smaller its orbit is? It only takes Mercury 88 days to move around the Sun. That's just about 3 months, much less than an Earth year. And Neptune back here? Look how big its orbit is. It takes Neptune 165 years to make its journey around the sun. Imagine having to wait 165 years for your birthday. That's a really long time. And that's our solar system. One star at the center, 8 planets, and lots of moons. The sun is the only star around here. The rest are far, far away. Thanks for helping me discover everything up in the sky, scientist. It's been an amazing journey, and we've made so many sky-inspired creations along the way. Now, I'm wondering about what the sky brings us, like rain, snow, seasons, and more. Maybe you can join me in making some more discoveries soon. Until next time, keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey.